Then we came to Płaszów and we worked for Madrid. We were very lucky. My husband and me, we both got day shift, which meant we went into the magazine where the ready-made clothes came in there, and I had to make out all the office work, like the Verfügung it was called, you know, how much goes out and what kind of article it is and things like that. So we had the day shift, which was very good. And the Lagerälteste, the Jewish Lagerälteste, his sister worked with me too. Now, we worked there for very many months, and finally they liquidated. They wanted to, the Russian front came forwards, and they wanted to liquidate Płaszów too. So they took 8,000 women. I was one on, with the 8,000 women, and they took them to, they wanted to take me to Stutthof. And a Jewish Odeman who knew me very well from Tarnów, even he was working in Tarnów and then came to Krakow too with us. So he knew me, and my husband actually asked the woman I worked with, who was the sister of the Jewish Lagerführer, Schilowitsch's sister, Mrs. Schnitzer was her name, Fella Schnitzer. She was very good friend. I mean, she seemed to be friendly to me, but when my husband asked her, can your brother take my wife out from the transport, she said, no, we cannot do anything. And I saw all these people who were taken out, who were working with the Jewish police. So, but the Jewish policeman came with water, and SS chased him away, but he said to me these two words, go in the back. They don't have enough room for everybody. And I did that, and I came back to Płaszów, to the camp, and then I was saved again because I worked a little while more for Madrid, and then Madrid and Schindler were friends too. And Schindler said to Madrid, how about coming with me? I'm going to make a factory in Brünnlitz, in Czechoslovakia. But Madrid didn't want anymore. Maybe he wasn't able to do it because he had enough money made already on the Jewish workers. So he said he is not interested. But Schindler made the factory. Now, Mr. Titch, who was a wonderful, he was a German, but he was, I don't believe he was even a Nazi, but he worked there, he wasn't on the front. He was the manager of Madrid in Krakow. So he knew me because we had some contact, you know, he came into the magazine, and he said one day there's a transport going to Brünnlitz, and I said, oh, can I go, because every time there was a transport, I never volunteered to go no place because I knew it could only be worse, not better, because I didn't know whether I will even make it, you know, so I always refused. I never officially volunteered for anything, but this I volunteered because I knew that here is no chance to live at all, and maybe there will be a chance. And I believed in Mr. Titch because he was really honest looking to me, he had an honest face. And so he said, okay, I can put you on the list. And I said, I have a husband and a brother. No, he put them on the list too, who were working for Madrid too. So we came on the list to Schindler. And Schindler I never met before. And so the first time when we came, of course, when the list was made, there was a lot of tummel, and everybody wanted to be on the list, and everybody wanted to go there. And then I knew maybe it's good. So, but then we were only 60 or 70 people altogether from Madrid taken to on Schindler's list. And the list was not touched, for one reason, because they did not want to have anything done to Titch, because they knew Titch's word is very, very important. So we were on the list to go to Brünnlitz.
Can you tell me a little bit more about Płaszów?
Oh, Płaszów was terrible. I can tell you about Płaszów. And Płaszów, first of all, I got once very sick. I had very high fever, and I went into the Krankenstube. Now, as sick as I was, I didn't want to stay there because they knew that, God forbid, if you stay there a little longer, you might get to Auschwitz. They will take you out anyhow. One day, it was very, very a cold day. It was in May. Mengele, Dr. Mengele from Auschwitz came with some other guys, and they had tables set up, and we had to stand there naked. Everybody was naked, and they had like files with paper, and everybody had to march down the aisles, and Mengele was looking you over. I was lucky I wasn't, they did not take my name, but if he saw somebody who was a little fragile looking or so, they just put the number on it. We had numbers. And the next day they came and they took them to Auschwitz. That was our Płaszów. Another thing was in Płaszów, one day they all called us down, and there were big loudspeakers in Płaszów on the Appelplatz, and there were the children who were saved by Schindler, because he had a factory outside from Płaszów for a while in Krakow, and these kids were saved. There were maybe by 300 children or so. There was a big truck, and the truck came and took all the children away, and they were singing a lullaby on the loudspeaker, good evening, good night, if God, in German, of course, if God wants you to, we will be awakened again. So that was a terrible day for us too. We saw the parents wanted to go with the children. Of course, they couldn't go. I was so lucky I didn't have children. I would have committed suicide when I saw them.